high school winter concert. It's so nice to see you all here. And I know that what you're thinking right now is you just can't wait for your kids to be home with you for an entire week. Well, we're almost there. And if your kids are ever been as excited as mine, I know that we're all in for a treat. And I love that this concert right here sets the whole thing off. We do everything right. Thank you for coming out. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Aaron Garceau. I'm the band director here. You're going to see lots of great music. For those of you who are here for the October band concert, we're going to try not to make it quite that long. I hope you all brought cushions, though, just in case. We are starting off this evening with the Wind Ensemble. Hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
while the percussion is getting set up, I'll just tell you a quick thing about this next piece, and that is, it's not one that I even heard until this year, going through an old record that I had of a whole mishmash of stuff. Never heard of the piece before, and I found it in the stacks, and I pulled it out. It's really cool. It goes from 6/8 to 9/8, and these guys, it became, for some of them, a favorite. For others, the bane of their existence, and they're glad it's over.
Thank you.
and make way for the concert choir anymore.
Thank you. This next song is a cute arrangement of Here Comes Santa Claus with some wonderful soloists.
Thank you.
shuffle. Whoa, this shuffle will just take a second.
Pieces by themselves.
themselves. Thank you, concert choir.
Thank you.
This next song has a little surprise in store, a silly one. We hope you enjoy it, because we thoroughly enjoyed it.
Thank you.
So I brought this song to Mr. Garceau. I mentioned, I bought this song on J.W. Pepper, and it's got an instrumental arrangement to it. What do you think? He's like, that sounds kind of nice. I'm like, good, because I bought it, and I gave it to him. We just really like to do something combined between our groups, because we don't get to have them together that often, and it's really good for my singers to sing with something other than a piano. So this song is Run, Rudolph, Run. I think you'll recognize what band recorded it from a long time ago. We have a couple wonderful soloists. Before we do this piece, I want to say thank you from the choral end, because my part of the concert will be over after this. And please remember that after, we're going to take a brief intermission to reset the stage. There's a wonderful bake sale up on there to support one of our lovely instrumental students trying to go on a big trip. So please go and support our students and go to the bake sale. Thank you so much.
Right now, and the very first piece that we're going to do for you is actually a suite. This is one of those pieces where three things happen and there's silence in the middle. Now, each suite is going to feature a one performer doing a solo. You're going to want to clap, as well you should, because it's going to be fantastic. The issue is, it's not that kind of tune, so I would suggest everyone do a silent clap during those portions. Now, here's the other thing, a little kink in the armor. So the first featured instrumentalist is Miss Denise Berger on the flute. Decided to schedule surgery like yesterday or 2 days ago. And while she's supposed to be standing up here, because of that surgery, she's going to sit where she is. Get away. So unlike the others, she will not be standing up because the doctor told me that she can't. This one is, it's actually not as long though as it sounds, so silent clap in the middle and then a big rousing clap at the very end. This one is called Christmas Concerto.
almost did a good job not clapping in the middle.
Thank you.
Okay, I forgot to ask, for how many of you was that the first time you ever sang on stage? You've all sung it? Okay, good job, Sean. Alright, this brings us to the last piece that the concert band is going to do. This one I found in the back, I didn't even know I had it. We pulled it out, it was a lot of fun. And very quickly turned out to be their favorite song, so we changed it up a little bit, we left it a little bit, and this one's going to be our closer before we bring on our illustrious alumni and the winners on the back on stage. This one's called Hava Nagila.
Thank you. church.
I'll hold it for you. Okay, so at the end of last year, Ms. Turner and I found out some stuff in our cabinets that had been sitting there for a good long time. I believe the last, there were some awards that were in there since 1982 or 83 was the last time that it was done. And so we looked back at everything and we were thinking, oh my gosh, you know, we really should pick this ball back up and run with it. And so we sat down and we determined who in our programs deserved the awards that we had. And then I also started thinking back on how I should have done it earlier, because there were, you know, a few students who really stood out over the years, either representing us at all states or New England or just doing all kinds of work in band. And so I actually wrote to the committee that does the John Philip Sousa Award, and they only award one, maybe two of these a year per school with extenuating circumstances. And I asked them for four extra ones and let them know that we started this late and I wanted to retroactively get some of these out there. And I figured that this was the best time to do it because most of those people are here tonight, which, you know, makes sense because, you know, that's why they're getting these. So last year, the John Philip Sousa Award was awarded to Mr. Cameron Nielsen, who has come back and joined us. Cam was one of those kids who would just come in for every band and play with any group and led the pep band the first year was here, and it was really terrific. Second time was here. And so I thought back on the year previous, and there was, from 2017, a young person who I felt, man, if I had that award back then, it should have gone to this person. This person came into the band rather late, led the first MVU pep band, and then did an even harder job aside from auditioning for district festivals and making wind ensemble. Also became the pianist for our musical, which is the hardest undertaking you could possibly do. So I retroactively got an award for Grace Coburn, 2017. And then, going back another year, there's a young man who was not only a leader for his section and his group, but again, would come in and play with it, everybody and anybody. He represented us at the New England Music Festival. He represented MVU all 4 years at the All-State Music Festival. For the last week, he has come in, actually, and played with both the concert band and the wind ensemble in the lead up to this. 2016's award definitely had to go to Mr. Judah Ward. The person to whom I award the 2015 is not here, so I'm going to wait to embarrass them later. We are going to jump back about four decades. This one got the most question from the award committee when I was talking to them on the phone. But this one goes out to a person who not only has fostered music in his own kids and grandkids and continues to play music and has been at every one of these alumni things, but also the person who helps me through all of the parades that we do is kind of another ear to lean on when these guys are driving me crazy on the bus. And I think you all agree that for 1972, Marshall Clue should definitely send this concert out to the bay. Folks, this is Sleigh Ride. It's our annual tournament.